So, it's no secret by now that Ultimate's buffer system is flawed. However, understanding of the buffer system is, from my experience, pretty poor across the community. With the proper knowledge, you can learn how to reduce your misinputs and even exploit it for faster movement. Let's get the basics out of the way first. If you input an action within 9 frames of another action ending, your input will come out in the first possible frame. By simply holding an input, it's also possible to have it come out in the first possible frame. This system is pretty easy to understand, but it's the exceptions to these rules that catch people out, so let's take a look at them. The first two main exceptions in the buffer system are platform drops and fast falls. If you try to drop through a platform during the end lag of something, you cannot buffer actions normally. You have to use hold buffer. However, if you do hold buffer, you'll likely end up just crouching. To properly do a platform drop, you have to start holding down from the last 4 frames of end lag. Let's take Fox's Nair as an example. So, if I hold down from frames 1 to 3, Fox will crouch when he can act on frame 8. But if I hold down from frames 4 to 7, Fox will properly drop through. And again, you have to continue holding down. If you let go of down before the end lag completes, no action will come out at all. Also, while I'm talking about platform drops, they're not actually completely instant. The game will consider you grounded for 2 frames, and then the drop through will actually take 2 frames itself. This means that all drop through aerials effectively have an additional 4 frames of startup. For buffering fastfall, the same 4 frame window applies. The earliest Fox can fastfall during his short hop is frame 13, so as long as I begin holding down from frame 10 and keep holding it by frame 13, Fox will fastfall as soon as possible. This 4 frame window also applies to hit lag. You cannot fastfall during hit lag, but you can buffer a fastfall towards the end of it. So let's take Fox's Nair as an example. At 0% it has 11 frames of hit lag, so if you do a falling Nair, you'll have to input the fastfall from frame 9 of hit lag onwards. This is why sometimes it can feel hard to fastfall after landing moves. You have to wait until the hit lag is nearly over, and then you have to input your fastfall. Remember that when I say this falls under hold buffer, you won't actually be holding down. Realistically, it's very hard or outright impossible to hold down an analog stick for just one frame, so as long as you input down just before your end lag or hit lag finishes, you should be fine. This can speed up your platform movement a lot, and also help for combos. Remember that inputting an aerial cancels your fastfall, so this also can allow you to fastfall, do an aerial, and then fastfall again to save a few frames. Rolls and spot dodges are among some of the most infamous examples of poor buffering in this game. Now, Nintendo claimed to have fixed this issue in 5.0, but from my testing, I don't actually think they did anything, to be honest. Basically, what happens is that if you're in the air, input shield plus right, left, or down, and then continue holding shield, the game will buffer an option in that direction as soon as you land. While we wait for Nintendo to, you know, actually fix this problem, there are two ways around it. First, when landing, let go of shield and press it again. The dodge misinput only occurs as long as you continue to hold shield, so this will correctly bring out shield as you land. The second example is a misinput that I often get. When I try to fastfall into shield near the ground, I end up buffering a spot dodge by accident. To avoid this, try to train your muscle memory to input the fastfall before you hold shield. By doing that, both the fastfall and shield will come out correctly and no spot dodge will occur. There are certain actions that can't be buffered at all, as the buffer system will only read one input at a time. This means that any action that requires multiple inputs like a dash attack, dash grab, or dash action in general cannot be buffered. For these, you have to wait for your dash to begin, and then input the attack, grab, smash, whatever you're doing. So, if you're playing Wolf and get down throw to forward tilt instead of dash attack, that means you're inputting the dash attack too quickly, and the dash isn't actually coming out before you press the C-stick forward. Speaking of forward tilt, for some reason it's impossible to buffer an angled forward tilt with the C-stick, but you can do it just fine with the analog stick. Yeah, I have no idea why this happens. Lastly, you cannot buffer full hop aerials at all, so let's talk about the biggest issue with the buffer system, aerials. This has been well documented, so you probably already know this, but I'll go over exactly how this works anyway. So, there's an exception to the rule that multiple actions can't be buffered, and that's for short hop aerials. For the sake of clarity, I want to specify there's a difference between the short hop macro and short hop buffered aerials. The short hop macro is when you press attack and jump within 3 frames of each other, which is guaranteed to give you a short hop aerial, regardless of how long you hold jump. While this system removes the ability to buffer full hop aerials, it's actually not what causes the main issue. If you input jump along with up on the C-stick, the game will still give you uppers. The problem with this system is that whenever you buffer a short hop aerial, the game will give you an aerial based on where your analog stick is at the time of the move coming out, and not whenever you input the move originally. Unfortunately, there's no consistent workaround for this. It can be exploited for attack cancelling, which you should learn about over here on my Smash Corner channel, but otherwise, you're better off just trying to avoid buffering if you can. For stuff like up airs, it can also help to move your analog stick up at the same time to make sure you get the up air, but obviously that will make you drift for your bears and fares. Speaking of drift, if you do a bearer fare on the first airborne frame, you will always drift slightly in this direction. To avoid this, I'd recommend practicing doing rising aerials that avoid the drift. Similarly, for full hop aerials, try to practice getting Fox's full hop up air to auto cancel and battle for its platforms. This is a pretty tight window, but ultimately doable with practice. So that about wraps it up. Sorry to end on quite a downer ending with the aerials, but I hope you learned something about the buffer system. Anyway, for those of you returning from my previous videos, hi, it's been a while. I may start making videos for Fox again. Also, I'd love feedback on this video. Is this too information dense? If so, I can cut back on it in the future. Or is this kind of thing fine? If you can tell me that, it really helps me out. And of course, thanks for watching.